You can see that biosphere reserves are ecosystem oriented. The activities in core zone of biosphere reserves are managed by three acts. And that's why you can see that either it can be a tiger reserve, it can be a lion reserve, it can be an elephant reserve. So different types of reserve they would be called. Hello everybody. Now on this platform of KSG, myself Ashish Kumar is welcoming you. Now, we would be discussing one topic of environment today, and that's called as biosphere reserve. So, when we talk about biosphere reserve, देखो, protected areas जब कहा जाता है, तो protected areas में कई संरक्षित क्षेत्र आते हैं, जिसमें biosphere reserve, जिसे हम कह सकते हैं जीव मंडल संरक्षित क्षेत्र, उसके बाद राष्ट्रीय उद्यान, which is called as national parks, and also wildlife sanctuaries, जिसे कहेंगे वन्य जीव अभयारण्य. So, all these things are included in the protected areas. Now, when we talk about protected areas, first of all, let's take up biosphere reserves. Biosphere reserves are areas of terrestrial or coastal ecosystem. They would be declared as reserves under the Man and Biosphere Program of UNESCO. And the Man and Biosphere Program of UNESCO was started in the year 1971. So, biosphere reserve की घोषणा इस तरह की जाती है Man and Biosphere Program के अंतर्गत, जहां तक जीव मंडल संरक्षित क्षेत्र है तो उसकी घोषणा इस तरह की जाएगी, लेकिन वन्य जीव अभयारण्य तथा राष्ट्रीय उद्यान की घोषणा की जाती है राज्य सरकार द्वारा. There is a difference between declaration of these three protected areas that we have talked about. When we talk about biosphere reserves and the difference it has with national park and wildlife sanctuaries, we can see that biosphere reserves are ecosystem oriented. वो पारिस्थितिक तंत्र अभिमुख होते हैं. When you talk about wildlife sanctuary, they are species oriented. वो प्रजातियों की तरफ अभिमुख होते हैं. And when we talk about national parks, राष्ट्रीय उद्यान की बात की जाती है, तो राष्ट्रीय उद्यान में मुख्य रूप से बल एक जानवर के संरक्षण हेतु दिया जाता है. This mainly for protection of one animals, and that's why you can see that either it can be a tiger reserve, it can be a lion reserve, it can be elephant reserve. So different types of reserve they would be called. Now another difference between biosphere reserves, national park and wildlife sanctuary is that which is more comprehensive. सबसे व्यापक कौन है? तो यह देखा जाता है कि जीव मंडल संरक्षित क्षेत्र जो है वो सबसे व्यापक protected area है, और इसके अंतर्गत there would be more than one national park, there would be more than one wildlife sanctuary. For example, suppose Kaziranga Biosphere Reserve is the highest biosphere reserve of India. It includes the Kaziranga National Park also. That another difference between the three protected area is that how human activities are regulated. Now human activities are more strictly regulated in national parks. No hunting, no cultivation. But as far as wildlife sanctuary is concerned, cultivation would be permissible, harvesting would be permissible. In case of biosphere reserve, hunting is also permissible in certain conditions. It does not mean that ki hum aur aap jaakar wahan par shikar kar sakte hain, because shikar karna itself is can land a person in trouble. So we cannot hunt. It would be only permissible for the forest dwellers or the tribals who can hunt to gather their foodstuffs. So in this way, we can talk about the differences between biosphere reserves, national park and wildlife sanctuaries. When we talk about the parts of biosphere reserve, there are many parts of biosphere reserve. In 1983, there was a conference of UNESCO और UNEP का कॉन्फ्रेंस था, जिसमें सम्मेलन में यह घोषित किया गया कि बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स के चार भाग होंगे. एक भाग को कहा जाता है कोर जोन. नाउ कोर जोन मींस दैट ह्यूमन इंटरवेंशन इन दिस एरिया इज नेग्लिजिबल, वेरी लेस, एंड ओनली एजुकेशन, रिसर्च एंड ट्रेनिंग कैन बी अलाउड इन दिस एरिया. Core zones are also present in national park, but the activities in core zone of biosphere reserves are managed by three acts. The Forest Act of 1927, also we can see Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, and also the Forest Conservation Act of 1980. Now the second zone is called as buffer zone. Buffer zone mein kya hota hai? Buffer zone is a kind of zone in which jahan par manviya kriya kalap निम्न स्तर पर उसे अलाउ किया जाएगा. Now you can indulge in hunting, fishing, timber collection, also grazing. But hunting would be only permissible for forest dwellers. Hunting would be only permissible for tribals. They can hunt those kind of animals which are least concern according to IUCN, and they would be hunting to gather their food stuff for the अपने भोजन के लिए ही वो शिकार कर सकते हैं. और उसके बाद देखते हैं कि इस क्षेत्र में जहाँ पर ग्रेजिंग भी अलाउड है, टिम्बर कलेक्शन भी अलाउड है, तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि वहाँ पर किसी तरह का वन नाशन होगा. There won't be any kind of deforestation taking place in this area. Now restoration zone, जिसे हिंदी में हम लोग कहते हैं पुनस्थापन क्षेत्र. Now this is an area where due to environmental degradation, the activities have suffered. The degradation has taken place on a large scale, and that is due to mainly anthropogenic activities, human activities. So this area needs to be restored to its original form. इसे क्या करेंगे? पुनःस्थापित करेंगे और इसके लिए वन रोपण करेंगे बड़े पैमाने पर. तीसरा जो लास्ट जो क्षेत्र है उसे हम लोग कहते हैं स्टेबल कल्चरल जोन, स्थायी सांस्कृतिक क्षेत्र. नाउ दिस स्पेल्स, दिस रिफ्लेक्ट्स द कल्चरल डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व. बिकॉज ह्यूमंस हैव सर्वाइव्ड इन नेचर फॉर सेंचुरीज, इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू सेपरेट द कल्चरल लैंडस्केप विद द नेचुरल लैंडस्केप. आर कस्टम्स, ट्रेडिशंस, रिलीजियस बिलीफ्स आर ऑल लिंक्ड विद नेचर. This depicts the cultural diversity of biosphere reserve and also includes the traditional land use patterns, paramparagat bhumi upyog ki jo paddhati hai, which also constitute the cultural diversity. Thank you students, we will meet again in another video.